Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Art Keller Field for today's game between the St. Mary's Bells and the Carthage College Firebirds. Let's meet today's starting lineup. First, for the visiting Bells. At attack, number one, Christiana Singler. At attack, number four, Paige Lyons. At attack, number seven, Julia Gorski. As a midfielder, number 10, Erin Dotson. At attack, number 11, Mia Salazar. On mid, number 15, Lindsay Hertzman. On defense, number 16, Kate King. On mid, number 17, Valentina Rubio. On defense, number 19, Elizabeth Borassa. At attack, number 20, Reese Bauer. At defense, number 22, Alyssa Grant. And on goal, number 30, Emma Smirdzinski. The head coach of St. Mary's is Amy Long, and she is assisted by Caitlin Sears.
On attack, number 19, Piper the Fever. On defense, number 22, Hannah Kohlert. On mid, number 23, Rachel Harris. And on goal, number 33, Alessandra Almendarez. The head coach of Carthage is John Sung, and he is assisted by Rebecca Congle. At this time, we ask that you please rise and remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Thank you. Welcome one, welcome all. It's NCAA Women's Lacrosse on the Firebird Broadcasting Network. I'm Peter Ferreri. Thank you for joining us from the beautiful Art Keller Field in Kenosha, Wisconsin, at the home of Carthage College. Another outstanding season underway for these two squads. St. Mary's and the Bells come in 2-0 overall on the early season as the home Firebirds of Carthage sit at 1-1. Again, we thank you for joining us this crisp afternoon. Snow was projected to be falling overnight. It did not happen. Beautiful conditions for the first weekend is in March. Not much more you could be asking for given the time of year and the circumstances. Two top teams coming to play each other in their respective conferences. We talked about the Firebirds, 1-1 overall. They lost their season opener, their home opener, February the 18th against DePauw. That was a 14-9 loss. Bounced back in a big way last week on the 25th of February, beating Marion University 18-5. And that was, of course, led by the charge of one of their outstanding players, one of their great leaders, and that's Rachel Harris. She is the reigning CCIW Offensive Player of the Week out of Naperville, a superb performance in her team's first victory of the year this season. That was last Saturday in the CCIW. They announced that she, of course, was the CCIW Offensive Player of the Week. First of the season for Harris, of course, who earned two Offensive Players of the Week honors last season. Firebirds wearing the home whites with red numbers and letters and black trim. The visiting Bells of St. Mary's wearing the very dark navy uniforms with a blue trim and white numbers and letters as well. Sun peeking through. 6 to 10 inches of snow was predicted yesterday afternoon overnight. Not a drop seemed to have touched here. Some snow from prior weeks and snowstorms still on the ground, but that has been shoveled away, pushed past the sidelines, and we are in store for an outstanding matchup between an MIAA top-tier team and one of the top projected teams in the CCIW. Looking for a run. Good marking up on the defensive side with 10 already left on the shot clock. Shot no good on the far side. With 4, with 3, with 2, they should be resetting that shot clock. And the official is calling for that resetting of the shot clock. And shot clock has been reset, and teams are underway. I believe the official still calling. There we go. Early season jitters with shot clock controls, but we're set. We're lined up. Beautiful, beautiful afternoon in Kenosha. Swiped away from behind. That'll clear things up for number 18, Maddie Burney. Her fifth year at Trinity High School. That grad level, extra COVID year leadership that this Firebirds team is going to lean on, along with Rachel Harris, for so much of the season. Very successful last year, of course, for this Carthage squad. They, of course, look to continue that success into their 2023 campaign. And we're getting the restart back from X. Swinging around the near side. Quite a few freshmen getting the start for this Carthage squad. They had quite a few leaders to replace at the end of last season. Both teams still looking for that first goal of the afternoon. Making a run in. That might be a whistle. And they're actually saying that's going to go the way of the Bells. So good job on the offensive side, on the defensive side by St. Mary to draw that infraction. Some penetration going low off the left leg of Almendara as one of the best goalkeepers in all of the CCIW. They're going to say, though, however, the St. Mary's athlete stepped inside the circle. So Amandera is now very generously coming out of goal. As St. Mary's now, I'm shocked Almendarez hasn't retreated more quickly. That's a situation where now she does have to hustle back a bit with St. Mary's getting possession. And the reason I say that is, you know, sometimes you see that long-range shot attempt dodging left to right, back to X, mistimed, and that's going to be a flip possession back to Carthage. So just an ill-advised pass to Julia Gorski out of Indianapolis, Indiana. As Almendarez now bringing the squad up. Definitely looking to not have that ride pressed against her. As now the Firebirds look to set up something offensively on their behalf. I appreciate the different dynamic between the gear of the two goal keeps. Almendarez definitely. Oh, shot up. Good. Top shelf first goal of the afternoon. Fire it up for the Firebirds. Elizabeth Oda out of Clarkson High School gets that first
goal for Carthage, number 7.
For the Firebirds. Outstanding play, outstanding communication. I was talking about the goal keeps, and next thing you know, Oda decides to dodge and make a run. It was a lot of St. Mary Bell players on their heels. And again, Elizabeth Oda just showing her skill set. Senior leader for this squad. Oda already 6 goals on the season, second on the team to Rachel Harris. That's now her 7th, so she will be tied as goal leaders for Carthage. Draw control going the way. Of the Firebirds again. So swinging around, looking for an opening. Again, it was a nice isolation goal by Oda. Just took advantage of the situation that was presented to her, delivered it home. Bounces back toward X. Quick pass in and bring it home. Another goal. Oda says, give me 2. Let's bring it back. Outstanding play and passing. So right now it just seems one of the keys. She's got back-to-back goals. We're just about 5.5 into this opening quarter. But the reason that bears mentioning is Oda, already an outstanding talent, already finding 2. Elizabeth Oda out of Clarkson, Michigan. That middle attacker. Daughter of Carrie and Rob, marketing management, economic minor. All classes I could not take. Last season, CCIW's All-Conference second team appeared and started in all 19 contests last year. Led the team in goals with 71. So already leading the team in this early 2023 campaign. Oh, good job jumping in the lane is Higgins. Higgins now facing the ride, or withstanding the ride face on. And this quick 2-0 score with 9 remaining in the opening quarter. Looking to set up things offensively now is Maddie Burney, the fifth-year player out of River Forest. Swings to the right side, back to X, looking over the middle, nothing there. Nolan was open. Quick pass, my goodness, point, blank, range, bang! Another goal for the Firebirds. What a turnaround for them, and by that I mean lost their opening game of the year against DePauw, came back very strong against Marion, and now a outstanding 3-0 lead just like that to start this contest. And I believe that's going to be a timeout called, and it will. So St. Mary's College of Notre Dame, Indiana comes in undefeated on the year. They're taking their first timeout. We'll take a quick one with them. We'll be back. Peter Ferreri on the Firebird Broadcasting Network. Welcome back, Firebird Broadcasting Network. Peter Ferreri from Carthage College in Kenosha at beautiful Art Keller Field. Bit of an overcast sky. Things were sunnier at opening draw. However, things have really heated up for the Firebird offense. 3 goals already, 1 by Rachel Harris and 2 by Elizabeth Oda. Draw control, again, pass to the near side. Oda's got the lane. She thought about it. Ooh, just pulled back. The defense for the Bells was on point, but couldn't quite get the stick in the lane. Right attitude, though, right mindset. Swinging to the right side, over the top now. Looking for the outlet, nothing there. Back to X. Oh, near side, shot up! The high Gouda! Another goal for the Firebirds. What an outstanding play. Rachel Harris. Rinse and repeat, my goodness. She was trailing her teammate. Trailing her teammate. What a beautiful play. I mean, when you look at the offensive setup for that, her teammate, I believe it was Oda, called for the ball first. That drew not only one, but the slide defender. Rachel Harris came right up from behind, wide open. The goalkeeper, Zminski, not much she could do with a point-blank attempt against her. Bang! Mzinski, on the year, has played the 90 minutes, 9 goals allowed, 10 saves. St. Mary's runs down the ground ball on the, looking after the draw, and they're able to come away with it. So the opening few minutes leaned that of St. Mary's. Very quickly, though, turned the way of the Firebirds. Bells try to answer back on the ground. There's a whistle. Reset of the shot clock, and that's going the way. It looks like it is, so that's going to go the way of the Firebirds again. Staunch ride man defense. As the players setting up at their near and far side bunches. Coming out of that formation, it's kind of like a 5 wide receiver run in football that happens right here. in the fall at Art Keller Field. Almendara is very aggressively moving her way down. Now she's in almost a sprint back. Because if that were to go the way quickly to a bell, I could very quickly turn around. And there it is, Elizabeth Oda now getting possession. It's not the overall speed of the Firebird squad today. It's the quickness. It's the awareness. It's the IQ of what they're able to bring. Looking to the far side now. Bernie had that one set up. Over the middle tip. Oh, that's just a good tip in the air. That's a horseshoe-type play. We're still about 2 weeks away from St. Patrick's Day, but pull out the clover as that just tipped off of Oda's stick and went to Harris's. Free position. Making his shot down, no good. And that's going to go the way just based on the angle for St. Mary's. Quick outlet pass for Madzinski. Now, as I was mentioning, right before the first goal was scored by Oda, Madzinski, no sleeves, just gun show on display. On the flip side, Almendara is all the extra padding is needed. Oh, just a miss on the inlet pass to Dotson. And they're going to reset the shot clock, and that's going to be another infraction against St. Mary's. So they're just not getting the breaks right now. Misguided pass by Almendara, but just hits the ground. And able to pick it up, she kind of pushes the team. Go ahead, run. As the Firebirds now looking to extend that lead. Freshman Higgins in the game, along with number 19, Lefevre, the other freshman. Lefevre doing a lot of work on that far side of the arc. Quick pass inside, swiped away. Harris picks up the pieces again. Just that next level of quickness that Harris has. Running in, down, goal, another goal for the Firebirds. The super athlete, that is Carthage College. Number 19, the freshman, the aforementioned Piper Lefevre. Heating things up for the Firebirds. Piper Lefevre. 6 goals already for the Firebirds. So Rachel Harris with 7. Lefevre with 6. Oda. She had 6, I should say. Offensive output. 5-0 the score. When you look at what St. Mary's has done, a very quiet player today, surprisingly enough. Is Lindsay Hearnsman. Again, she's the reigning MIAA Player of the Week. As she is trailing now against Bernie. Just not much she could do as her team hasn't been able to win in the circle. And again, you say that things start on the defensive end with the goalie. But if you don't win the draw control on a consistent basis, back at X now. Can the Firebirds get a 6-0 lead here in the first? Again, the Bells 2-0 on the year. They defeated Concordia of Chicago 15-6 and also beat Beloit 13-2. They've only allowed 8 goals on the season. Already 5 here in the first. Oh, quick point blank range shot. Goal once again for the Firebirds. Firing on all cylinders. What an athletic move for number 7, Elizabeth Oda. All around great athlete displaying her prowess. Firebirds 6, St. Mary's 0. What a start. What a run for Carthage as Oda now give her the hat trick. 3 out of the 6 goals for Carthage coming the way of the outstretched stick of Elizabeth Oda. Lining up in the circle now. St. Mary's desperately trying to get possession. And the ground ball is just going to keep rolling. And I think the whistle, yes, the whistle is going to go the way of the Firebirds. Have a minute. We want to thank you all for joining us on the Firebird Broadcasting Network. St. Mary's of Notre Dame has only allowed 8 goals on the season, already 6 in the opening quarter. Firebirds have just been shooting at such a high percentage. 6 goals, 6 assists on 9 shots. So waiting for the official. Let's see, set up at X on the near side. Can the first goal be scored by Rubio? I'm sure she'd love to find it. Nice move. Dodges it. Oh, right to the outstretched stick of Almendarez. Rubio had the step. Might have taken one too many steps. And Almendarez just tracked the end of her stick. And here comes the ride. I've been waiting to see that all day. Mia Salazar putting the pressure on Almendarez. There were so many times where she was, my goodness, past midfield easily without any pressure. Quick pass inside. Oh, just off the left pipe. It's going to bounce back, and that'll stay the way of the Firebirds. J. Firebird's back at X now. 30 seconds on the shot clock. About a 3-second differential in between. Shot. Oh, just off the crossbar. Shocked there wasn't an excessive follow-through called. But nonetheless, Firebirds pick up the pieces, trying to roll through and spin. Nothing there. Ground ball picked back up by the freshman, Lefevre. And at the end of one, a outstanding lead for the Firebirds as they lead at home against the Bells of St. Mary, 6-0. We'll take a timeout when we come back. Quarter number two from our Keller Field. I'm Peter Ferreri. Welcome back, Firebird Broadcasting Network. I'm Peter Ferreri, live from Art Keller Field in Kenosha. The snow never came, but the heat on the field for this Firebird squad would have definitely melted away any of that snow, as my goodness, a slow first 2 minutes, I guess you could say slow by the standards of what was then the output the rest of the first quarter. My goodness, 6-0 is where things ended up. As an outstanding first quarter for this Firebird squad. Kind of tipped the stick and flipped around. As trying to get an angle there was Heitschmidt. Teams have flipped sides. Shot. And there is a change in goal already. So in at goal is going to be number 23 for St. Mary's. And that's going to be Mila Swayaki. So Swayaki now in at goal. Can't put a lot of that on Madzinski, as the Firebirds were just getting such point blank goals. There's not much you could do against that. Quick pass, point blank, boom. Again, I believe they're going to say violation, though. And they are. So goal will not count. Trying to take a stab at it again is Heitschmidt. And coming away with a turn of possession just that fast, Emma McDonald, the sophomore out of Tartan Senior High School. Point blank again. Oda, ooh, just pulled the wrist too high. But being that it was a shot attempt, her teammate was back at X to maintain possession. Heitschmidt now back to X. Looking over the middle, nothing there. It's going to matriculate to Swayaki, who looks for the outlet pass, not able to clear it. Oh, my goodness, back in, but right into the net. A Swayaki out of Marco Island, Florida. Swipe from behind by Oda. She's trying to take advantage, as Valentino Rubio was on her heels. So resetting of the shot clock right now. We have the officials talking to each other. Is that a green card is going to be issued. Not sure where the infraction was, but coming off the field. Actually, going to have, okay. So coming off the field looks to be Hannah Kim. As changing positions then was Lefevre. Shot. Left side. Goal! St. Mary's gets their first one of the afternoon. Number 7, Julia Gorski, out of Indianapolis, Indiana, the pride of Roncalli High School. The 5'6 junior attacker finally getting on the goal for St. Mary's. It was becoming a situation where you were going to say to yourself, my goodness, how quickly can Carthage get to 10 to possibly then get that running clock to expire the game? I mean, it was getting to that point. But St. Mary's, a resilient squad, a winning squad, has not tasted defeat yet this spring 2023 season. Jaw control keeps it herself right away to Maddie Burney. Looks for Oda. Burney now retreats back to mid. Switches sticks. Helped out by teammate Hannah Kohler. Back at X, looking for any movement. Resetting up is Burney. Not afraid to take the long shot if needed. There's going to be that whistle. Waiting to see who's going to get the mark. It's going to start back at X. Or is it going to be free position? It's going to be a free position by Oda. Space violation. Can Oda get number 4? The righty lines up, right foot ahead, stick at her right knee. Down, goes for the bounce shot, not there. Swiped away, trying to get good positioning, able to do so, is McDonald. Looking for the pass inside, swipes right, no good. Right on the spot, though. 25 seconds are going to remain. Reset of the shot clock back to 60. Crisp pass to Burney. Down! Goal! Bounces off the carpet and in, not much. That's what Yaki could do, but watch that. Go near pipe. As the Firebirds able to get that goal right back. Extend that lead back to 6. They lead 7-1. Just as you thought that maybe, possibly, that singular goal from St. Mary's and Gorski may have been the not only stoppage of the offensive output of Carthage, but maybe it was going to lead to a run of their own. NCAA lacrosse, such a game of runs that you thought maybe, just maybe, that would have been it. But nonetheless, Carthage gets the goal right back. Moving around. Crisp pass to the top to Burney. I really like what I see from Lefevre on in her freshman year. Dodges inside. Has the lane. Oh, bounces off the part of the stick that looked like between the hands of Swayaki. What a unique positioning for a block, but hey, you take it any way you can get it. The official having Carthage reset up looks to be number 8, Kylie Higgins, out of Algonquin, Illinois. The pass is there for Burney. Point blank. Boom. Goes the fireworks as Carthage. My goodness, where are you going to stop Carthage at this point, beautiful pass O'Higgins is back at X. And there's just only so many defenders you can put defensively on a given mark. They played the inside, they played the outside, but in the middle, after about a 2 second delay, was Maddie Burney. And Trinity's own delivers another goal, 8-1. Carthage now extends their lead to 7. That was Burney's second goal of the afternoon. Up to 4 on the early season. Again, even in a losing effort, they'd scored 9 against DePauw 2 weeks ago, then put up 18 against Marion. So change at goal, not necessarily yielding positive results so far for St. Mary's out of Notre Dame. Outside, inside, nothing there. There's that outlet pass. Burney fires upper left pipe. The floor is lava. Another outstanding goal off the crisp, precise passing of Carthage, 9-1. The Firebirds just pouring it on. 6 goals in the first, 3 more in the second so far. Again, it's not a matter of St. Mary's playing any type of poor defensive. It's just the passes are exactly where they need to be. The shots are where they need to be. And when they are not contested shots, just based on the field of awareness of Carthage, my goodness. False start called. It looks like it was a false start called against Singler. Burney passes far side, Harris. Harris, a great player in her own right. Throughout her illustrious career for the Firebirds. Near side, trots Burney, Lefevre, can she dodge in her pass? And Lefevre is going to have a free position. At the far right hash, at the 8-meter. Can Lefevre bring in 10? Down, hits it, yes she does. The only prescription is more cowbell as Lefevre brings the lead to 9, 10-1 over the bells of St. Mary's College. Piper Lefevre, what a freshman campaign for her so far. Out of Prairie Ridge High School, the 5'9 attacker. Daughter of Susan and Steve. an elementary education major, 4-year honor roll student high school, conference championship team, sectional championship team in 2022, 2-time all-conference selection, 2-time all-sectional selection, all-state team last year in 2022, 64 goals, school record in goals. Yeah, she's a good one. Almendarez, haven't said her name in quite a bit of time. A 10-1 output. Shot in, Almendarez on the spot. I had the pleasure of calling quite a lot of CCIW lacrosse last season, and none better in the conference than 33 between the pipes for Carthage. St. Mary's now with a rare possession in this second quarter. They got their lone goal and then were silent since. Again, to note, there is a 10-goal lead running clock rule. Carthage one away from that. Possession back to Carthage. Pass to Lefevre. What a find for this Carthage squad. Looking for the outlet. There it is! The 10-goal lead for the Firebirds. You can't stop them right now. You can only hope to contain. Number 2 fired up for Shannon Heitschmidt, the freshman out of Marist High School on the south side of Chicago, Illinois. Her 4th goal of the season. And just like that, it is 11-1. Clock is now running. 5:20 remaining in the opening half of action. And I believe that's going to be a violation against Carthage. So to note, should St. Mary's score a singular goal and bring it back to within single digits, the running clock does stop. So anytime it's within that differential, Almendarez picks up the pieces, literally picks it up with her hand and puts it into the netting. She was looking for a stretch pass, but didn't want to just fire away. Nobody marking her right now, so soft ride. As she has that near and far separation, and now Harris, nobody on her. She has an outlet to the near side, dodges. And that's going to be a free position. So close call, because it looked like Harris just kind of ran into the defender, but the offender wasn't necessarily feet set. So right at the 90-degree angle, down, far side, no good. Ground ball picked up by St. Mary's. The speed of St. Mary's now to be tested. Christiana Singler now out of Louisville, looking for coast to coast. Dodges inside on the pick and roll. Loses possession. That'll be a violation. Called against Carthage. Almendarez picks up the pieces. Up ahead to Bernie. She has gotten her miles in today. As she's picked up from behind. Good job making up that lost space by Rubio. One of the shining players for this St. Mary's squad. Nice save that time by Suyaki. Pass ahead, good outlet pass. Can the Bells stop the running clock? Reese Bauer would like to think so. Hands off to Singler. Singler back to Bauer. Bauer trying to piece through point blank. Bounced away. Singler picks up the pieces, though. Running it down is Dotson. Dotson out of Oak Park High School in California. To 10 remaining, running clock in the second, 11-1. Peter Ferreri on the Firebird Broadcasting Network. Good job finding the lane for Carthage, Hannah Kohlert. She's getting swiped from the front, from behind. I believe that's going to be a yellow called, and it is. A yellow going to be called against Mia Salazar out of Fishers, Indiana. A slashing call. She came down from that 12-6 position. Reset of the shot clock. That'll be 2 minutes, so the remaining time of this second quarter, Carthage will play a woman up. Inside, down, goal, feeling hot, hot, hot. Number 23, yet again, Rachel Harris, showing her offensive prowess. Harris came into today leading the team with 7 goals of her own. And just like that, the 12th goal of the game, Harris with her third. Clock continues to run. I'm sure St. Mary's would like to find one before half if they have enough time. Whoever gets the draw, look for a very quick run at it. I did see some bubbles floating by, so that's not sure where that came from. Looks like there's some young fans in the crowd blowing bubbles after a goal. Okay. Didn't know if my eyes were deceiving me. And that's going to be the end of the second quarter. So slipping right before, I'm not sure if they were going to give her the free position, but nonetheless, clock continue to run. So at half, the Firebirds, with a resounding lead 12-1 over the Bells of St. Mary's. Can St. Mary's come back in this one and get that that clock to stop? Or the Firebirds continue on and get back-to-back wins to go to 2-1 on the season? We'll find out when we come back. From Mark Keller Field, I'm Peter Ferreri on the Firebird Broadcasting Network. Welcome back, Firebird Broadcasting Network. Hello, everybody. I'm Peter Ferreri. Glad to be with you for my first game of this 2023 CCIW campaign. Nice non-conference matchup as the Bells of St. Mary's College come into Kenosha to take on the Firebirds of Carthage College. As we talked about, and if you're just joining us, a pretty back-and-forth first 2 to 3 minutes of the game. And then next thing you know, Firebirds poured it on with 6 per quarter. So 6 in the first, 6 in the second to get that running clock. It is 12-1 as draw controls have just very much favored that of the Firebirds. 27-10 the shot differential, 12-1 the goals. And just like that, so Firebirds looking to pick up right where they left off. Again, Rachel Harris climbing up. With those numbers, goal after goal. Looking on the right side, down. That goes back, but it'll maintain possession for the Firebirds. So coming into today, Rachel Harris was at 96 goals. And so with 3, she is at, of course, 99. One more would hit the 100 career mark. What an accomplishment. I'm sure she'd like to get that today. So things really cooling off temperature-wise. Sun set. I should say the clouds covered up the sunshine. A few minutes into the contest this afternoon. I'm sure that somebody back in the locker room at halftime might have seen, okay, Harris needs 4. She's at 3. Why not get that at home? I know her family are avid watchers of the Firebird Broadcasting Network, so thank you for them and to them for watching at home. Back to Harris now, 34 on the shot clock, plenty of time. Harris back to X, misplayed over the top, ground ball, Lefevre picks it up. What a find for this Carthage squad. Coach John, his second season at the helm. Back at X, looking near side. Quick pass, Oda. And as that shot clock expires, oh, they're calling for a reset. So Carthage will maintain. Shuffling. Bit of a gap defensively. They're giving them a little bit of space, but I think they want to be ready to react more It was such a press defense in the first half, they couldn't adjust to when there was a crisp pass otherwise. So I think they're consciously giving that bit more space here in the second to be able to get a more successful slide. Pass, Harris, goal! 100 goals in the career of number 23 from Fishers, Indiana, Rachel Harris. Congrats to her. What a career accomplishment for number 23. When you think about how lofty of a number that is, that shows so many levels of consistency in play. A huge factor, of course, being health. Maintaining that good health, that good level of fitness to be able to play game after game, season after season, to reach that career 100 mark. And not only that, having the skill set and the athleticism to score early in your career and often enough in your career to then post 100 career goals. 13-1, your score. Clock continues to tick, and Rachel Harris, congrats once again. St. Mary's now. Now, we talked about two things to keep in mind. One, St. Mary's undefeated on the year, so not used to not winning. So they have the wherewithal and the skill set to find the back of the net. But with that being said, non-conference matchup, but you'd also like to see what St. Mary's has in the tank. Topic of conversation I've had with many current and former NCAA women's lacrosse players is you never want the running clock against you. And when you do, even though you know you may not have the time to come back and win the game, a small victory or triumph is at least getting that running clock to stop. So with that being said, St. Mary's needs 4 goals total to get to that point. So they need 3 more. Can they get one here? Looking long range and finding it! I have mentioned that multiple times in today's contest. The aggressiveness of Alessandra Almendarez to come out of goal after not being contested on the ride, and a little bit of accuracy and a little bit of luck finds the way for number 10, Aaron Dotson. So Aaron Dotson, from the 30-yard mark, sails it into the air. Didn't have to fire it hard. Almendarez couldn't turn around. Very frustrated. You could see her teammates, including Harris, talking to her like, hey, it's okay. It's all right. But again, that's an early season conversation this team has to have. And that being like, hey, that is a sense of susceptibility. If you're going to just run back like that, turnovers happen. I've called many a games here at Art Keller Field where similar situations, not such as that in terms of, okay, long range shot, but, you know, goalie tries to clear it, somebody finds a lane immediately 2 steps and fires, even if the goalie's in position. So with a goalie out of position in this circumstance, something I'm sure the coaches are going to have that conversation about. Now, you also want to keep the aggressiveness of Almendarez up, as she does better than almost anybody in the CCIW. So something to keep in mind, that they could be like, sure, okay, quick laps, we gave them one, but we'll make sure that things are screwed down and tightened up and we don't give those opportunities often. But again, when you have your goalie so keen to being able to circumvent no pressure, when the rest of her team's given a strong ride, okay, go ahead, take it up, see where you go with it. You know, but at some point, maybe if that's going to continue to happen, you find an adjustment, you find another player that sits back a little bit just in case, because Dotson just had to get in the lane, flick of a wrist, goal. Answering right back, like clockwork, This time, another one for Elizabeth Oda. Oda having herself a day. That'll be her fourth goal. So Elizabeth Oda out of Clarkson, Michigan. Another great game for her. Past her season mark. Of course, only the third game of the season, but three goals was her high coming into today. Her career high. Of course, she scored 71 last year. What a breakout year for her. Her career high, by all accounts, is 7 goals in the game against Guilford, March the 16th of last year. Did also put up 4 against this same St. Mary's squad in a 21-10 victory. And that was Feb 29th, 2020. Was looking to be a good early career season for her before, as we all know, what happened. But even 3 goals against DePauw, 3 goals against Marion, and 4 so far against Carthage. We talked about career high 7 in the game. All time, Carthage 16-5 against St. Mary's. Last time they met, the last time they met, it was 16-5. My apologies, that was last year, almost to the day, the 5th of March of last season. All time, 3-1, Carthage leads over St. Mary's. The lone loss coming March the 27th, 2019. And that was in Notre Dame, Indiana. A 21-10 victory for St. Mary's. It's like a space violation. Harris hits the ground hard. Face mask seemingly knocked off. I always say every time I call a women's lacrosse game, you want to talk about toughness. Look no further than women's lacrosse. No pads, no gloves, cage over your eye sockets, and you get a stick. Goalies have a little bit of padding. Running all the way through, bounces down. Very slow to get up. From what it looks like is Rubio. So she is slowly going to walk that one off. As the sun seemingly trying to peek through. Just like that, just 2 minutes and change remaining in the third quarter. Running clock by 3 goals. 14-12, 9 goal and less lead would stop that running clock. So that's why we talk about the factor of that running clock in a comeback victory. Called another game recently. That one bounces. No goal. But I called a game just about a week ago at the NCAA level where it hit the running clock, but mere moments later, the team that was down by 10 got within 9 and then chipped away. Differential, I think, at the end was a 4-goal victory. But still, you see, you go from 10 to 4, and it's all based on that clock. So reset up the shot clock. Minute 6 remaining in the third quarter. Firebird Broadcast Network, Peter Ferreri, honored to be back at the helm for some NCAA women's lacrosse here at Carthage College. So Carthage more than happy to let this one run out. 2 goals only in the third, but again with a running clock. 6 in the first, 6 in the second. Still finding 2. Hey, why not? Make it 3. Finding the back of the net. Number 4, Rosie Nolan. The 5'4 freshman out of the Mother Macaulay Liberal Arts High School in Chicago. The Fighting Mighty Max. What looks to be her first collegiate goal. A lot of fans happy. I believe the announcement was either a free pizza, free t-shirt. Somebody's getting something free. But what you're getting here is a outstanding offensive and defensive output by the Firebirds of Carthage. They lead 15-2 at the end of 3. 15 minutes remain between the Firebirds and the Bells. We'll be back shortly on the Firebird Broadcasting Network. Welcome back, Firebird Broadcasting Network. 15 minutes on the clock. It will be running as the score stands 15-2. Hello, everyone. I'm Peter Ferreri. Thanks for joining us on this Saturday afternoon. Possession goes. Well, first mark was to go to Carthage. Then they flip sides. Some players running into one another. Looked unintentional. Swing to the left side. Tough contested ground ball taken by St. Mary. Swatted away. Picked up by Aaron Dotson. One of the shining stars for the St. Mary squad, albeit only 2 goals. She has had a fairly decent game offensively and defensively. Again, had that stretch goal from 30 yards out. One of the 2 goals scored by St. Mary's. Crisp pass inside. Down and goal. Give the point by the officials. Been waiting all day for this one. Valentina Rubio has tried so many times. As the official gives a little smile. But my goodness, has Rubio, she has taken a shellacking today. Slow to get up time and time again, but all smiles there. Again, it's been a winning formula for this St. Mary's squad, and by that I mean they've won both of their games, so I was not expecting, per se, a running clock in the second, but nonetheless, that's where we stood, and we still stand at a 15-3 lead. So St. Mary's needs 3 to stop the running clock. Looking ahead, the St. Mary's squad have some games coming up. Whittier, Cal Lutheran, Redlands, DePauw, and Edgewood in March. As the Firebirds now can say, we can use the word content with just running out some of the clock, setting up some offensive attacks, trying out some plays. Valentino Rubio, we talked about the sophomore. Chose St. Mary's because of its community education and just the overall opportunity to play college lacrosse. 4-year all-conference honorable mention, all-American academic achievement, also in swimming. National Honor Society member at high school. Played all 18 games last season for St. Mary's. Led the team in ground balls, 69, and caused turnovers, 40. 12 draw controls, 4 goals, and 2 assists. Was the MIAA Defensive Player of the Week and was first team All-MIAA. A tentative nursing major right now. Harris bounces one in. The carpet goal, 101. I'm sure her family is looking on as the sun peeks through and is smiling. Rachel Harris. And another one. 16-3. Clock continues to run here in Kenosha. Season high for Harris is 6 goals. That's her 5th today. Pass underneath. Oh, top shelf again. The high cheese for number 8, Kylie Higgins, the Huntley High School product. Higgins had 4 goals coming into today. Her first today. Harris with an assist on that one. And the score at 17-3. So as comfortable of a lead as you may see. Higgins' daughter of Andrea and Corey, a biology and neuroscience major. All sectional lacrosse recipient last year. All-conference selection, team captain, National Cup District Central highlight, her all-star game, and of course, a member of the NHS. It seems that in order to play for Carthage, if you weren't an NHS member in high school, might as well find somewhere else. I jest, but so many academic scholars on this team. Pass inside. Oda, my goodness. Oh, they're saying circle violation. They're saying Oda stepped in. And even on that one, Suyaki just kind of softly put her stick up. It's like, what can I do against this? She's a step away from me. But again, it seems to be the situation, what's been the story most of the afternoon. St. Mary's just not having an answer to the multi-level attack of the Firebirds. That one flicked away. Oh, I think getting hit in the mouth is Bernie. Seems to be okay. There goes Rubio, full sprint. Almendara's on the ready. As Rubio finally slows down, that was a full 60, 70-yard sprint. Goal by St. Mary's. Number 20, mark it down for Reese Bauer out of Garden City, New York. Again, even with that clock running, good to see some goals getting scored. Get your name in the stat book. Reese Bauer coming in. One goal coming in today's game, so her second. As we look ahead for this Firebird squad. Wednesday, March the 8th, home game against Concordia before they return Saturday, a week from today, against Calvin University. And both those games, of course, will be on the Firebird Broadcasting Network. I'll be back for those. Always thankful for my time at Carthage. Near side, looked, went up to down, not there. And I believe they're going to have a free position at the floating hash. And they will. So Emma McDonald with 4:15 on the clock will have the free position floating hash near sideline. Passes in. Bernie tries to bounce it. And that'll stay Carthage. Bernie wanted it right away. Harris wanted it. Harris got it. What a day for Harris, like she's had so many times in her career. You can't stop her. You can only hope to contain. Another goal, 17-4, with 3:40 remaining in the contest. As some of the St. Mary's team going back and having a quick consoling conversation with the freshman out of Marco Island, Florida. And that's Milo Suyaki just saying, hey, it's all right, not our game. Again, they won two, so it's not as if this is a squad that doesn't know how to win and have been blown out in every game. I mean, they have been victorious so far, just faced a red-hot Firebird squad this Saturday afternoon in early March. It's going to be a fun season of CCIW lacrosse. I cannot wait for each and every game. There's Rubio. Will she take it herself? Finding the lane. There's the whistle. And Rubio going to have a free possession. I don't know if we're going to get a yellow or not. We aren't, so Rubio going to take her time going back to the hash. She'll have the 8-meter free position. Gets the whistle. Takes it herself. Keeps it herself. Scores herself. I believe it's a goal. I think, right. So, my apologies on the delay. Rubio held the stick, and then when her team huddled around her, just gently dropped it to the ground for, you know, formality purposes, but also show, hey, I scored a goal. We dropped the stick. Valentina Rubio, very good game in spite of all that has happened so far. Just an onslaught for Carthage. Not much St. Mary's can do against that one. But as we talked about, two games in the next 7 days before the spring break trip for Carthage. They head out of town, head to Kentucky to take on Center College and Transylvania University before coming back home against the Scarlet Hawks of IIT, Illinois Institute of Technology. That's a 6 p.m. contest, Wednesday the 22nd of March. Another fun season ahead for this Carthage squad. It's one of those, you know, not to be cliche, but it's, you know, they don't rebuild, they just retool. Last year, 16-3. Lost against University of Chicago, the number one ranked team, to end their season 21-13. That was May the 7th of last year, so they have waited to come back and find victory time and time again here. 16-3 overall record last year. What a season they had. Pass up, blocked away, Almendarez. And that'll be a goal. So with 30-plus seconds remaining in the game, St. Mary's gets another feel-good goal. As stated, any goal is a good goal. Add it to the stats. Show, hey, we can still do this. Because a lot of teams, when you are down so much, or I should say by so many goals so early, you may just say, all right, let's put in some bench players. Let's just kind of coast into the next game. This St. Mary's team did not do that, especially in the fourth. So we may not even get a draw before time expires. But shout out there to Allison Grant getting the goal. And that's going to be it. That's going to be all she wrote. As the Firebirds bring their record above 500, 2-1 on the season now, defeating St. Mary's 18-6. Multiple goals scored by multiple players. Oda with four. Bernie with three. Lefevre, the freshman, with two. But of course, we'll call Rachel Harris 6 goals on the game, surpassing the 100-goal mark in the season. Congratulations to her and that outstanding career accomplishment. Again, we thank you for being with us this afternoon as St. Mary's falls to Carthage again 18-6 from Art Keller Field in Kenosha. On behalf of all the staff, the players, administrators, and directors, outstanding afternoon of CCIW NCAA action. We'll be back midweek for more great CCIW lacrosse. Again, the fourth was today. Big victory. They come back on the 8th against Concordia University, Wisconsin, and then on the 11th against Calvin. For the producers, the directors, for John, for Sam, for Mike, for all the camera operators, victory lap for the Firebirds. As we sign off, again, 18-6, the Firebirds come out victorious against St. Mary's from Art Keller Field at Carthage College in Kenosha. Have a good rest of your day, everybody.
Home safely and have a great rest of your day.